hidden in a desert for nearly 2,000 years, discovered just 60 years ago. Now, one of the greatest archaeological finds of the 20th century, the Dead Sea Scrolls.
Our first speaker tonight is going to be Dr. Robert Eisenman. He is well known to us here at the CSULB community. He is the department chair in the Religious Studies Department. He has a PhD from Columbia University. He has a master's in Near East Studies from NYU. He has a bachelor's from Cornell University in philosophy and physics. He is a well-known author. He has authored The Dead Sea Scrolls Uncovered, James, the Brother of Jesus, and The Dead Sea Scrolls and the First Christians. He is professor of Middle East religions and archaeology, and very noteworthy, he led the struggle to free the Dead Sea Scrolls and was a consultant for the Huntington Library in San Marino on this decision to open their archives. So without any further ado, I would request Dr. Robert Eisenman.
That if you want to find out the historical Jesus, you have to find out the historical James. And this is the problem scholars have been facing for a long time. Who is this? And this quest for the historical Jesus has been going on for 200 years, even including people like the famous Albert Schweitzer. And it hasn't been solved, and scholars don't agree on it, which is shows how difficult it is. But I come at it that you really have to go to this other person. And then people, particularly Muslims, say, this other person, even Christians say that. Jews, they don't even know who he is. James, the brother of Jesus, they've never heard of him. Because he's not in the scripture, at least the Muslim scripture, he's not in the Jewish scripture, and he's just a sort of vague person in Christian scripture. And my conclusion is, who and whatever James was, so was Jesus. And when you get into the James problem, which leads you to the Dead Sea Scrolls also, you find that the ethos is very Islamic. It's very apocalyptic. And the key to James is, what's in the Quran too? Over and over again, Muhammad is reciting that you are saved by believing and doing good works. Believe and do good works. Over and over again. It must be repeated about 30 times to my count. That is the Jamesian position in the New Testament. James says, you are saved, we're saved not like Paul says, by faith alone and grace. We're saved by faith working with works. Well, faith is believing. So believe and do good works is the essence of the Jamesian position. It's my point of view that it's the essence of the Dead Sea Scrolls, and it's my point of view that it's the essence of Islam too. So when you start looking for Jesus, you really have to go aside from Christian scripture. Two other points before I close, because I want to give my colleagues a chance to have a few says in here too, of course. Another thing that many Muslims don't realize is that Muslim dietary law is based on James's instructions to overseas communities. In other words, they abstain from carrion, things sacrificed to idols, pork, and I forget the blood or whatever it is, the third or fourth thing, part of the Quranic injunctions about eating are actually the essence of James's instructions to overseas communities in the book of Acts, where he says abstain from blood, things sacrificed to idols, strangle things, by which he means carrion, and fornication, which all Islam is against fornication. So these are the instructions James gives, and they reappear in the Quran. So I think that the Quran is the heir to a Jamesian strain of anti-Paulinism. Now, finally, this Jamesian strain of anti-Paulinism, which permeates the Quran, expresses itself in works righteousness. In works righteousness. Now, Paul, which is the Islamic position too. You're saved by the works that go before you, the works that you send before you, strict works righteousness. Now, Paul, on the other hand, is the faith man. You're saved by your belief in Jesus Christ. And that's the argument between Paul and James. In the Western world, Paul won out. And what we call Christianity is basically Paulinism. But the final issue between Paul and James on this faith versus works matter centers around Abraham. And if you remember, for the Quran, for Muhammad, for Islam, this also focuses on the salvationary state of Abraham too. So I think that Muslims would be very interested to look into the James matter, and they would find a lot in common with not only James, but what parallels James in the Dead Sea Scrolls. And once we approach James, we approach the historical Jesus. The final point I wanted to make was on the Gospels themselves. As a secular scholar now, I honestly do not take the Gospels as history. And I think more and more secular scholars are coming to that position. The Gospels are a kind of Paulinism, that is Paul, retrospectively imposed on the Second Temple period. And that's where the Dead Sea Scrolls really help us. Because the Dead Sea Scrolls show us another form of messianism, closer to Jamesianism and closer to Islam, and not close to Paulinism at all. And I think we get the kernel of both this third way that finally goes into Islam, as far as I'm concerned, and that you, or many Muslims in this room, would feel very close to if you knew it. Thank you very much.
الصلاة والسلام عليك عليك يا الصلاة والسلام عليك عليك يا الصلاة والسلام عليك عليك يا سيدي عليك يا عليك يا سيدي عليك يا سيد الأولين والآخرين الصلاة والسلام. عليك يا